Philippine shares rallied on Friday, notching its second weekly gain in 5 on window dressing. The PSE index up 0.6%, closing at 66.25. And net foreign buying bigger now at 436 million pesos. For those who are keeping track, the PSEI is up 2% for the month of April and up 0.9% year to date. Joining us to weigh in is Carlos Angela Temporal of UniCapital Securities. Carlos, good to see you again. Welcome back to Market Edge.
Yeah, good to see you again, Mimi.
All right. So, Carlos, how are you reading the tea leaves now? What are you seeing?
Well, for the index, after last week's uptrend, I expect the index to trade sideways during the early part of this week as investors await the conclusion of the Fed's meeting, which should be out on Thursday's dawn in Philippine time. And Philippine inflation rate also, we should give guidance on what to expect for BSP's meeting. Although we think the BSP would still likely consider the outcome of the Fed's meeting, given the potential repercussions on the value of so if the rate gap between the Fed and the BSP narrows below 100 pips. Therefore, given that these key events won't likely diverge from current expectations that have been priced in, the BSP could crawl further above and reach as a resistance at 6,700, assuming that we won't see any significant underperformance from big index heavyweights, which we think is also unlikely given how the earnings season so far has transpired. But then again, the index could only go so far for now since there's still those sticky recession fears abroad that could impose a ceiling on the index multiple.
Mm-hmm. All right. So, you know, there's a saying, sell in May, go away. Do you think that's what's going to happen this month?
Well, I think the same won't apply for this year. I think for May, this could be a good time to slowly accumulate, but still keeping some cash aside in case of any lockdowns from unexpected events. As in the past few weeks, we have some slight resurgence in COVID-19 cases. And if this escalates further to certain levels, then this could spell some downturns for the market.
All right. Looking at the calendar for this week, I think we have brief graphics for what to expect in the pipeline. There you go. It's a pretty busy week there. You've got the Fed rate decision, the ECB rate decision out on Thursday, and then Philippine inflation numbers for Friday. Just very quickly, do you think that the market will have more reason to be bullish this week, or as you said, just sideways, considering what you're expecting from the major events happening this week?
Well, yes, again, the week should, the index for the first part of the week should still trade sideways as they await these key events. But
so what's the market pricing in? In terms of the Fed and inflation, yes.
Yes, for the Fed, well, the market is pricing in another quarter point rate hike, and as well as for the BSP, another 25 pips. And for inflation, well, the market is already expecting that headline inflation should go down from the 7.6% in the previous month to 7% or below this April. So again, given that the outcome has a low chance of diverging from these expectations, then that could be the reason to be bullish on the market. But after this week, since again, investors are still waiting for those key events.
Mm-hmm. All right. Did I get that right? You're expecting the BSP to raise by 25 bips again, considering that the governor earlier said, if he sees 3 months of decelerating inflation, he's ready to hit pause. You don't think that's going to happen?
Well, I think for now, as if we go back to last year, Governor Padilla has been firm also on the importance of keeping the rate gap around 100 bips or higher. And if the Fed and if the BSP, I mean, if the BSP do take a pause in its monetary policy, then this could narrow down that gap below 100 pips, and we could see some repercussions through the value of peso. It could impose more volatility in peso, and I think and after that decision, we could see peso swing above 55 peso level again. Above 56 level.
All right. Carlos, if you have to rule out certain areas, like you think they're overvalued, Are there any sectors or areas that you think are fairly, maybe even undervalued at this point?
This point in the market, the property sector remained one of the laggards in the market, along with the telcos, given the impact of rising rates, inflation, and investor sentiment on these stocks. So if we do see the potential uptrend that I mentioned earlier, post the key events, it could be a tide lifting all boats situation, so investors would be better off positioning among these undervalued names.
All right. So far, you mentioned this, earnings have been good for the first quarter of this year, especially the banks, they're on the roll. But when you look under the hood, how's the quality of Q1 earnings? Are they really that good, or are you starting to see cracks?
As far as banks are concerned, much of their performance, we have BDO and BPI, much of their performance are mainly due to further name expansion and load growth. And these are key numbers that we are looking at when we analyze banks. So I think for banking sector, earnings quality remains good. Mm-hmm. And we have UPB being the lone underperforming in that sector. And the underperformance was mainly due to a company-specific factors rather than macroeconomic related factors. Right. So earnings so far, in terms of quality, is still positive, still good.
All right, still good. And for the rest of the year? Q1 has been so good, so the bar has been set pretty high, which is not exactly the best, because it's going to be harder to reach the bar when you go down the road. So what's your expectation for earnings for Q2, 3, and 4, for example?
For Q2, given the significant performance of a lot of corporate names this Q1, and a lot of them are expected to also release positive earnings results. We have upcoming earnings release from Ali Intel this week, which should also show some sign of a strong Q1 earnings. Given that, for Q2, it should be some Q&Q growth could be flattish.
All right.
But again, there's still some resiliency in terms of earnings. But this is coming at Q3, Q4, the narrative should be quite different. It should be more positive as we take in further easing of inflation, and also in the market perspective, as they factor in that potential rate cut coming end of year or early part of next year.
All right. I think we're ready for the blind item. Talk to us about the stock that you're monitoring closely. I think you like this stock. Don't tell us. Just describe. We're going to leave our viewers to guess what this is. So what do you have for us?
So I have this stock. I have been watching this for about 2 months now. Given how the underlying price of the commodity that this stock is selling has been on the uptrend recently, and this stock is one of the based on rumors, is one of the index plays for this coming August rebalancing, and also this stock is management has mentioned that they are aiming to be one of the leading ESG investment by 2025. So I think is that enough?
Yeah. Just one final question: upside in share price, how big?
So right now, I think upside, if we would look at the last traded price last Friday, upside potential is around 38% to sell for value, estimated for value.
38% upside. Sounds good. On that note, we're just going to have to guess which stock this is. Carlos, thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you soon.
Thank you also, Mimi. See you soon also.
All right.